Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I'm delighted to have this gentleman on the show, a great friend of the show, Mr. Gary Lightbody. How are you, sir?
I'm fine, thank you very much. How are you doing, Fergal? You all right?
I'm in good form because Snow Patrol are just on the cusp of releasing the Fireside Session. Snow Patrol and the Saturday Songwriters, you have been so given of your time and proactive over this whole lockdown nonsense. For a man that's doing 3 albums and a soundtrack for a TV show at the one time, for this culmination of songs, it's amazing for this to come out. This is 12 songs which were kind of written over 11 weeks by thousands of people. It's some sort of record here. 4,000 to 5,000 people are involved in this.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know the exact number of people every week, but it was about 4,000 or 5,000 people over the course of an hour every week that were involved in each session. We wrote songs together on Instagram Live for 11 weeks. We did 12 songs. I didn't know how it was going to work out. I didn't know if we'd get any songs when I started out doing it, but the very first time we did it, we got a song and I thought we'll just keep going, and over nearly almost three months we did the bones of an album. But obviously this new release will be an EP, so it's there's 5 of those songs coming out. And
now we've already got one of these, Reaching Out to You, which I really, really love. That's crunchy, soulful, kind of all about intimacy during lockdown, which is nice.
I think that there was sort of recurring themes. There was the theme of lockdown or isolation or feeling kind of like anxious or fearful of the future, and then there was the sort of the theme of sort of looking to the future, of looking to something hopeful, look the things that people wanted to be doing rather than the things that they were doing. There's that kind of duality through the whole thing, really.
You had to learn a kind of a new method of writing using other people's lyrics. So it was a kind of a, you know, you'd get a chord pattern, a melody, go off and come back. It's amazing. Like, was that unusual for you?
I've written music with people and I've written, you know, shared lyrics, obviously, with, you know, collaborations on other people's albums. But as far as Snow Patrol goes, it's the first Snow Patrol release that it's not been my words, really. I mean, a few words here and there just to tie things together. But I'll tell you one thing that it certainly is it removes the anxiety of staring at the blank sheet of paper, you know.
Oh wow.
That's one of the things that takes me so long when I'm writing.
Are you and lyrics. I have spoken about this before, the books of hieroglyphics that exist in your house. What was I saying that time, you know?
Yeah, exactly. And you know, it's a long process. But then with this, you know, like I was asking people to give me lyrics for 25-30 minutes, and I'd write down as many as I possibly could, so I'd have maybe 5 pages of lyrics to sort of pick from and choose from, and sort of time. I wanted each song to feel like it was, you know, it made sense as a song. I didn't want it just to be a series of non sequiturs, and it worked out really well. I think if people listen to the lyrics on these 5 songs, they all make sense, you know, and they've got a great flow. I'm very proud of them, even though I didn't write any of them.
You played a huge role in it, though. But you, do you know what I think is a beautiful concept, Gary, is you invited listeners to come in and feel significant. And I think that's, and can I just say this EP, some great songs are On the Edge of All This, The Curve of the Earth, Dance With Me, Light Years. Here's the funny thing. This is every penny that is made from this is going to the Trussell Trust, which supports food banks. These are a really, really good charity, and every penny from this is going to that. So what a worthy cause. What a worthy cause to get involved with there.
They're one of the best charities out there, you know, and I just obviously with a project like this, nobody should have ownership over it. It was always going to be going to a charity, you know.
Into the production on this, but you also had some guests into you, David Keenan, Graham Hopkins, who I'm very fond of from the Swell Season. Played with Therapy for a while in Frames as well. Great to have Graham in there too as well.
Graham did an amazing couple of drum parts for us. How he recorded it was like very inventive. It was kind of the archetypal lockdown kind of MacGyver recording. He put 6 iPhones around his drum kit and put the voice memos all onto record on the phones. And that's how he recorded the drum tracks for the EP.
This has made my day. I love these MacGyver stories of artists, particularly like Graham Hopkins, because Graham has been in with me several times and he is that guy. You know, he's the guy, if something goes wrong, like he's the guy who, if he sees a cowbell, he'll just throw it away. You know, but he's also that guy that is so intriguing that he was the only one that I would ever think that would do that, get 5 or 6 different iPhones and put them around. How brilliant is that?
It's amazing. We've been friends of his for, I don't even know how long, it just feels like I've known him my whole life, and he's as you well know, he's an amazing guy, and he's played with Snow Patrol many times, and he was the first person to put his hand up in the very first session. He said, "Whatever this is, I want to play on it." So he's always the guy that wants the, in the football terms, he's always the guy that wants the ball, you know.
So are you missing the road at the moment? Because I know the last time I would have seen you would have been the 15th of January when you played in the Olympia. Beautiful gig. Yourself, Ian and Nathan were down. And what a gig. I think that stripped back acoustic version for me, because I had seen you in Malahide literally the summer before. And it was like hit after hit after hit. And then the same thing, but very, very different in the Olympia. One of the things that stands out for me whenever you're on stage, and this is gas, and I know your dad used to use the term, you're making a Horlicks of it, right? Okay, right, that particular term. Every so often at Snow Patrol gig, not all the time, you'll forget a lyric and then you'll come back, which they're the best parts of those shows, you know that, because the music is phenomenal. But I love it. I always get a giggle out of that.
The best part of the show, Fergal, what you're saying is the best part of the show is when I shut the hell up and stop singing.
Absolutely not. But there's a stand-up comedian in you though, because every so often you do this, and for me it's almost like, you know, just forget the words versus just forget the world. That moment, I think when you said that in the Olympia, the amount of people that put their hands up and said words as opposed to world.
I know. I think that's one that people, I can never convince people that it's forget the world, because I think I've forgotten the words so many times at gigs that people just assume that that's what that lyric is a reference to, but it genuinely is forget the world. But anyway.
I know. I love that story. Listen, so you and the boys, any plans to get back on the road?
We're planning next year, shows next year, and we want to get back on the road and we want to get back out with our crew again. That's the thing about it, you know, it's like, it's not just the people on the stage that are sitting twiddling their thumbs. I'm anxious about it. It's all the crews, all the people that work behind the scenes to put the gigs on, you know, the lights and the staging.
These are the guys and girls who are first people on site and last people off site. That's it.
Absolutely. Yeah. You know what I mean? Our crew and every crew, you know, they're there in the morning and they're there until the morning. You know, they're leaving the site sometimes at 3 o'clock in the morning and getting to the next site at 8 o'clock in the morning or 7 o'clock in the morning, you know. So they do the hardest job in music. It's trying to get back to a place where we can get them, you know, back working again where they want to be, you know.
Yeah,
we're doing everything we can. You know, every band is trying to do things to figure out getting live shows up and running again, you know.
Gary, thank you so much for being given your time. Just to let people know again, the EP, it's called Fireside Sessions. It's Snow Patrol and the Saturday Songwriters. It's a phenomenal piece of work. It's due for release today. Get out, get your hands on it for a great cause. And Gary, I look forward to seeing you on the road again soon.
Brilliant. Thank you, Fergal. Take care, mate.